home students,
we lost
3 lessons. I am able to explain the first major unit of this topic, trigonometry, the measurement of angles. Now we shall take up in detail the main problems of trigonometry, starting with trigonometrical ratios, or you can call them as circular functions. Circular functions. Check out. In the previous 10th classes or 9th classes, you have studied the T ratios, trigonometrical ratios, simple introduction, and that too in the first quadrant. Here now we shall deal in detail the revolution of a line in all the 4 quadrants and the position of the revolving line in all the 4 quadrants. See, I just put up a circle before you because the name is circular functions or circular T ratios. So to start with, we must know the concept of what is T ratio, what is circular function. So we have a revolving line. Revolving line starting from OX trace out an angle theta. The revolving line is, we can generally take up as OP. Revolving line in the first quadrant, but it revolves in the anti-clockwise direction, the positive direction. I told you in my first lesson that if you revolve in the clockwise direction, then we get the negative T ratios, negative angles. But here we generally talk about the positive angles, anti-clockwise direction. So in the first quadrant, the position of the revolving line, and we draw a perpendicular on it. When you enter the second quadrant, the position of the revolving line is in this way. Come to the third quadrant, this OP again. And when you enter the fourth quadrant, the position of the revolving line is shown like this. This angle is theta. We generally consider, when we talk about the T ratios, generally geometrically we talk about the first quadrant, the revolving line we show. And moreover, in the general cases, we try to avoid the circles. It is understood. Without keeping in mind, we simply take up 2 perpendicular axes like this and just draw 2 perpendicular axes meeting at the point O. And then we say a revolving line OP starting from OX trace out an angle theta in any of the 4 quadrants. About the quadrants, I told you in the very beginning that we have the position of the revolving line. The revolving line is generally taken as OP in all the cases. See, the position in the first quadrant, the second quadrant, the third quadrant, ultimately the fourth quadrant. The position of the revolving line in the fourth quadrant is like this. Here we have this angle theta. So generally we avoid the circle and we talk about the 2 perpendicular axes meeting at the point O, revolving line OP starting from OX, trace out an angle XOP is equal to theta, XOP is equal to theta in any of the 4 quadrants as shown. Now keeping in mind this, let us come to our basic 10th class, the definitions like the T ratios. We have, like in this case, sine theta, S-I-N-E sine theta, write in short as sine theta. This is taken as MP upon OP. Therefore, the perpendicular upon the hypotenuse. We never say it is PM because we are dealing in the anti-clockwise direction. That's why we say MP upon OP sine theta, the first phi ratio. Second is, in the same way, cosine theta, write in short as cos theta, it is OM upon OP. Then the third is taken as tangent of theta, tangent theta, write in short as tan theta, or it is now MP upon OM. These are the first three T ratios. Check up. Sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta. That is sine, cos, and tan. The remaining three are the reciprocals, like we say cotangent of theta. It is cotangent theta, in short as cot theta, OM upon MP. The reciprocal of tan theta. Similarly, secant theta. देखो secant theta, right in short as sec theta, लेकिन इसको हम हमेशा secant theta ही बोलेंगे. secant theta, it is taken as OM, this is secant theta, the reciprocal of cos theta, it is taken as OP upon OM. Then we go for cosecant theta, cosecant theta, that is in short cosec theta. Reciprocal of sine theta, it is OP upon MP. These are the six T ratios before us. Sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. Reciprocal of tan is cot. Reciprocal of tan is cot. Cot, tan is taken as OM upon MP. OM. This is tan theta, MP upon OM. It is tan theta, MP upon OM. MP upon OM. The reciprocal of this is OM upon MP. Secant theta is reciprocal of cos. It is OM upon OP, it is OP upon OM. Then the cosecant theta is reciprocal of sine theta. It was MP upon OP, the reciprocal is OP upon MP. These are the six trigonometrical ratios, and we write it as T ratios. T ratios. And also these are called circular functions. And you know this you have done also in your 10th classes. About the relation between the six T ratios. See, these relations you have studied at your 10th standard level also. Here now let us repeat once again. Number one, tan theta is sine theta upon cos theta. Number two, cot theta, that is cos theta upon sine theta. Then the third we have secant theta as 1 upon cos theta, the reciprocal of cos. Fourth is cosecant theta is 1 upon sine theta. The fifth case we have in this case cot theta, that is the reciprocal of tan theta. Sixth, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Seventh, secant square theta is 1 plus tan square theta. Eighth, it is cosecant square theta is 1 plus cot square theta. So these are some of the basic results, the relations. Here, as I told you previously, I can just add in the form of corollary, one or two. See, we have sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, in the problems we can use sine square is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. This is the corollary. Similarly, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1, etc. That is, these results can be written in different forms. And these are called, previously also explained, corollaries. Okay? Now, let us take up a precaution or in the form of a note. Number one, remember sine theta is never equal to sine multiplied by theta. Should be noted very carefully. ये single एक word है. Sine theta का मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि sine is different और theta is different. Number two, it is sine square theta, not equal to sine theta the whole square. No, this sine theta square. Remember, sine square theta is not equal to sine theta square. Of course, it is equal to sine theta the whole square. But then sine square theta is not equal to sine theta square, but of course equal to sine theta whole square. Similarly, we say sine the power n theta. That can be written as sine theta the power n. Matlab, this is not, once again we say, not equal to sine theta the power n. This should be very clear, and it is possible for all the six P ratios. Moreover, you remember number, this is the second number, three, third. Dekho, sine theta the power minus 1 is equal to 1 upon sine theta. Remember it. Sine theta the power minus 1 is equal to 1 upon sine theta, but it is not equal to sine inverse theta. Remember, this is different. It is, we read it as sine inverse theta. ये हमारा नेक्स्ट में जाके काम आएगा, अभी नहीं. अभी यू रिमेंबर दिस, साइन थीटा इनवर्स इज वन अपॉन साइन थीटा, बट नॉट इक्वल टू साइन इनवर्स थीटा. नाउ कीपिंग इन माइंड ऑल दिस, लेट अस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एक्सप्लेन मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस यू पीपल हैव डन एट योर 10th लेवल ऑन दीज फार्मूलाज, बट आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन ए फ्यू क्वेश्चंस सिंपल जस्ट टू रिमाइंड यू हाउ टू अप्लाई. The rest I will advise that you must revise your 10th level exercise on this chapter of sine square plus cos square is equal to 1, etc. Even then, let us take up a few questions. Question number 1. See, he says prove that sine 6 theta plus cos 6 theta is equal to 1 minus 3 sine square theta cos square theta. The first case, the very first problem, sine 6 theta plus cos 6 theta is equal to 1 minus 3 sine square theta cos square theta. Now see here, I will just take up the help of a plus b the whole cube. That is taken as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Now how it is applied here? See, we have sine square theta plus cos square theta the whole cube. Let us take up this for the solution. It is sine 6 theta plus cos 6 theta plus 3 sine square theta cos square theta into sine square theta plus cos square theta. Check out. We have a plus b the whole cube. Here you can put up the reason, because I just write down the formula before you. Sine square plus cos square the whole cube. Start with this. Sine 6 plus cos 6 plus 3 sine square cos square into sine square plus cos square. Now using the result, it is 1. It is taken as sine 6 theta plus cos 6 theta plus 3 sine square theta cos square theta into 1. And therefore, when we just simplify by transposing, sine 6 theta plus cos 6 theta is 1 minus 3 sine square theta cos square theta. So this is, we are able to prove the very first, very basic question, sine 6 plus cos 6 is equal to this. One more question I can put up before you. This is just a practice, nothing else, because all you have done at your 10th level. But still, see, it is we have like cos theta upon 1 minus tan theta plus sin theta over 1 plus 1 minus cot theta is equal to, he says, sin theta plus cos theta. See, sin theta plus cos theta. Just to remind you, nothing else. Therefore, solution for this, I take up the left hand side as the system is known to you, cos theta over 1 minus sin theta upon cos theta plus sin theta over 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta. मतलब ये है change this tan and cot in terms of sin and cos. I write down this is further equal to. See, I take up in this case the LCM here. It is cos square theta over cos theta minus sin theta plus sin square theta over sin theta minus cos theta. I think it is okay. See, sin theta minus cos theta, sin will come in the numerator. And you know one thing, in this case, we have minus a upon b, can be written as a upon minus b. And this is equal to minus of a upon b. I can put up in this way. Moreover, a minus b is written as minus common b minus a. See, for these two basic ideas, I write down here cos square theta upon cos theta minus sin theta. Here I take up one minus common, minus of sin square theta over cos theta minus sin theta. That is, I have taken minus as common from sin theta minus cos theta. It becomes minus of cos theta minus sin theta. And this is just cos square theta minus sin square theta over cos theta minus sin theta. When you factorize it, this is nothing but equal to cos theta plus sin theta is equal to right hand side. You please check out. This is the second question I have discussed. Just you note down this and the, see whether it is clear or not. Therefore, I will repeat. This is, first is this question number one, question number two. Cos theta upon 1 minus tan theta plus sin theta upon 1 minus cot theta is equal to sin theta plus cos theta. So what we do here, take up the left hand side, it becomes change into sin and cos. That is, wherever it is tan and cot, write there sin and cos. And use the basics, simplify up to this level. After this, we have this step. Minus is taken as common, LCM, and now this factorize, we get cos theta plus sin theta. Now the third question, it is cos theta minus sin theta is equal to under root 2 sin theta. Given, show that sin theta plus cos theta is under root 2 cos theta. It's a very important case. How to solve it? See, let us write down the solution here. We have cos theta minus sin theta is under root of 2 sin theta. Therefore, cos theta is under root 2 sin theta plus sin theta. This becomes equal to under root 2 plus 1 sin theta. And therefore, sin theta can be written as cos theta over under root 2 plus 1. Now, rationalizing the denominator, cos theta under root 2 minus 1 over under root 2 minus 1 under root 2 plus 1. This becomes under root 2 minus 1 cos theta upon 2 minus 1. That is under root 2 cos theta minus cos theta. This is a sine theta. And therefore, by transposing, we get sine theta plus cos theta is under root of 2 cos theta. This is the one here in the question itself. Now, these are some of the basics I have introduced before you today in this very lesson. But only the difference is that I have taken here all the four coordinates, whereas in your 10th classes, you have done only the first quadrant. So in the next lesson onwards, we shall just concentrate all the four quadrants, the nature of T ratios in the four quadrants, the sign conventions, maximum and minimum values of sine theta and cos theta of this sort. But that we can take up in the next lesson. But for today, please try to complete the problems like this, also from your books like NCERT. I think it is not given so much in NCERT, but 10th level NCERT or even RD Sharma plus one. Thank you.